Hello students, hope you all are enjoying all the videos which I am sending you, and these all the activities you are also doing at home. First of all, I would like to wish you a very happy new year. This new year 2021 should bring a good health, fitness as well as good success in your life. So let's start our today's topic with basketball activity, chapter 3. In this activity we will see another skill of basketballs. Last week we have seen the basketball skill of dribbling. Now we'll see the next skills of basketballs. So let's see this video.
In this video, you will learn how to do a layup. Used very often in games, the layup is the easiest way to score, as it is the shot taken closest to the basket. To shoot a good layup, work on these two steps: jumping and releasing the ball. First, jumping. The layup is a running shot, as you're shooting in the movement after a dribble. Dribble to one side of the basket using your outside hand so as to keep the ball out of your opponent's reach. Take the ball in both hands to start the layup, keeping it near your hip to protect it from your opponent. If you're shooting from the right of the basket, step forward onto your right foot first. Push off with this foot to take a big step forward without losing any speed. Put your left foot on the floor. Push off with the left foot to jump, raising your right knee in towards your chest to gain height. For a strong takeoff, your foot should be within the key. If you take your first step too soon, you'll be too far from the basket when you jump. If you step too late, you will lose all your speed and won't jump high enough. Secondly, releasing the ball. As you jump towards the basket, lift your right hand towards the hoop. Hold the ball from beneath, with your fingers pointing forward to do a layup. You can also try a push-up. By placing your hand beneath the ball with your fingers pointing upwards, ask for a classic throw. Release the ball at the highest point of your jump. Aim for the top right corner of the square on the backboard, and you will almost certainly score. If you're shooting from the left side of the basket, take the first step with your left foot and the second with your right, and shoot with your left hand. You can also do a layup facing the basket. To do this, you'll need to shoot without hitting the backboard. To master layups and get used to protecting the ball, try practicing against the defender and shooting from both sides of the basket. Over to you.
Now this is a beginner progression for teaching kids how to shoot layups. Okay? Sam's gonna start right here close to the basket. He's gonna start with his right foot forward, left foot back. He's gonna get low, so he's ready to explode. And he's gonna take a step with his left foot, jump, and shoot the layup. Go ahead and go. Grab the ball, come back and do it again. Right foot forward, now extend up. All right, after they do that for a little bit, we'll add two more points of emphasis for them to work on. Now, one thing I'm a big believer on is that you finish with your eyes. So we always talk about keeping our chin up, eyes on the target through the finish. A second thing that you'll notice is a lot of players, when they shoot their layup, they have the ball here and they sweep it to the inside of their body before they shoot the layup. When I teach defense, I actually tell my defenders on the fast break, don't go high, especially if you're not a leaper. Aim for their hip pocket, because most players will bring the ball back here. So what we're going to do now is we're going to start the ball in our right hip pocket, and we're going to keep it on that side and focus on that. Now these layups can be done from both sides of the floor. So if you're doing it on the left side, come over here, Sam. Rather than start with his right foot forward, we would start with our left foot forward. The next progression is to add the dribble to the layup. So right now, Sam's around the three-point line. If we're working with youth kids, we might start in closer to here. Now, just like on the first progression, we're going to start with our right foot forward. Okay, so he's got his right foot forward, he's going to take one dribble, then he's going to shoot the layup. Make sure to keep that in your right hip pocket, Sam. And we do the same thing on the left side too. Notice when he did on the left side, just like when he was in close, he started with his left foot forward. One more single.
I can tell you that I try to teach passing and catching, rebounding, two hands. So as you're passing the ball, you're passing with two hands. You're catching with two hands. You're rebounding with two hands. So the first pass is a simple chest pass. We have Klay Thompson and Ryan Anderson passing to each other. So again, it's just a simple warm-up. How about they extend just like they're shooting? They end up with their palms out, thumbs go down. Now, if they're gonna throw a bounce pass, you want that bounce pass to come up to where you can handle it. So Ryan wants that ball right in here, so we gotta bounce it there. Now, that means how far out do I bounce it? About 3/4 of the way. Simple, thumbs down, the same way. When would you throw a bounce pass? There's congestion, and there's a cutter. And I can get a pass through on a bounce pass, or I'm feeding a post. How about over the head? Well, when would I throw that? A guy's up on me, and I want to get rid of it. Same action, thumbs down, extend the arms. Thumbs down, extend the arms. It's over the head, but it's all the same. How about now, I need to sidestep. I'm guarding Klay, and I'm on him, and he needs to move me. You notice he held with two hands. He's not reaching, he's holding with two and then making that pass. He steps out lefty, same idea. He reaches out, he throws it. What if he's a big guy? He puts that hand up. I'm throwing at his hand. I'm giving it to him where he wants it. You want it over there? I'll give it to you there. Passing the ball, making your teammates better. If Ryan is a shooter, I'm not throwing this ball above his head. If I'm a good passer, this is now your 15, 16, 17. I'm throwing it so those seams are where he can catch it. He wants it in the grooves. If I throw it this way, here I go, he's got to move the ball around to get it to where he's comfortable. Throwing it with the seams, a little bit more advanced, but it's the same thing. I need to pinpoint that ball where I'm trying to throw it. If you're on the court and a guy can really pass, you're really happy. So why don't you be the guy to make everybody happy? Learn to pass that ball and pass it the correct way.
So students, hope you all are watching this all the activities videos and doing all the skill at home. So do this workout and enjoy your activities. Once again, Happy New Year, and do good, do better.